So Jeff Prophet going to be the fastest so far. Then Reagan Williams, Scotty Prophet, Brian Hemme, Lloyd Paxton, and Pete Wright. Your top five right now. So Reagan Williams going to jump to the top of the board, 14.806. Scott Prophet still going to be second. Brian Hemme now going to move up to your top three. With a 15.004, 15.004, Pete Wright fourth. So new quick time on the track, going to belong to the Wartburg, Tennessee native, the 32 of Brian Hemme. As you see, the 48 of Reagan Williams down there. Got a little steam coming out from the hood. So we're going to give these guys a couple of laps around Crossville Speedway. It is hot lap qualifying. So they get 3 to 4 laps around the high banks of Crossville Speedway to set their fast time. That's how they will start their feature a little bit later on in the evening. American Pro Late Models, you need to be in staging. American Pro Late Models, you need to be in staging at this time. Mobile Modifieds, you need to be thinking about it. So David Dunlap, going to be the fastest so far. Dakota Richards, Hunter Rich, Cameron Dixon, and Carl Stairs going to round out your top five in group one. Fixing to roll down group two. The 14 of Mike Brown, Mason Ferguson, going to be in the 21. That's going to be your second and final group in your dwarf car division. As once again, American Pro Late Model Series, you need to be in staging, gentlemen. There's the 17 of Todd Clark. Going to loop it around over in turn number one and two. So we're going to go back underway. Todd Clark got that thing straightened back out. So the 20 of Corey Galloway coming to a slow at the top of 1 and 2. Does that allow the caution flag to fly once again right here in group number 2? American Pro Late Models, you need to be in staging. Last call. American Pro Late Models, you need to be in staging. This is your last call. You have hot laps right here after our dwarf car division. So David Dunlap going to be your fastest in hot lap qualifying for your dual car division as we bring them to an end. Once again, American Pro Late Models, you should be there. American Pro Late Models, you should be there at this time. As we get ready for your Hey Jack Construction 40 right here at Crossville Speedway. And for that, I'd like to welcome once again back to the booth, all the way from the state that John Denver made a million about, West Virginia, Mr. Walter.
Don't forget, we'll be headed, of course, to I-75 Speedway tomorrow night. Twin 2,500 to win. Night number one here at Crossville. Night number two at I-75 in the Sweetwater Valley tomorrow night. We started the season off with a double feature there at I-75. First trip this year to Crossville Speedway, our other trip. Unfortunately, Mother Nature won that battle. Out on the Speedway, in the 9 Machina Stinger race car, entry for Golden Locks himself, Zach Seiss. Out on the Speedway, in the 70, Tyler Price at a Greenback Tennessee Tractor Supply. That is a Rocket chassis underneath him. In that 70 machine as he works down the back straightaway. A little bit of smoke out of the 3 machine as he works down the back straightaway. Waiting for a couple of more cars to blend actually onto the racetrack to join this first group. Dakota Smith out of Powell, Tennessee, in the 3 machine out on the track. Still that smoke trailing behind that machine. The bed store on the 73, the 2020 series champion, Trevor Seiss, in the 73, working down into turn number one. Terry Poor in the 2P. That is a Savage chassis for the driver out of Seymour, Tennessee, in the 2P machine. Bailey Cardwell in the 07B out of Knoxville, Tennessee. Group B, be ready in the staging area. Group B for the American All-Star Series, be ready in the staging area. And the final car out on the track, the 29 of Rusty Ballinger. Rusty Ballinger in a Warrior chassis. As the field's now going to be coming to green. Loud pedal going on the way to the floor. Here we go. American All-Stars presented by PPM Racing Products. Group A underway with this hot lap session. Terry Poor in the Tar Chevy. Savage race car entry working down into turn number one. In front of him in the Bruceville Performance 73 machine, that is Trevor Seiss. Seiss, always a threat to win in that 73 machine, a multi-time winner and series champion. Matthew Johnson out of Lancaster, Kentucky, in the 17J in front of Trevor Seiss. The 3D machine, that is going to be Dakota Smith into that machine out of Powell, Tennessee, as he works down the front straightaway. Caution is out. And we have the 2P of Terry Poore, the driver to Seymour, Tennessee, around at the start of the back straightaway, and that will draw the caution flag for the first time in this hot lap session for the American All-Star Series presented by PPM Racing Products. I also want to thank Risco Industries, the official aluminum and checkered flag sponsor for the American All-Star Series. Speaking of the American All-Star Series, race fans, don't forget about the merchandise set up directly over there towards the pit crossover gate with Miss Meta. She's got hats, she's got t-shirts, and so much more. Go check her out. Great prices. We got stuff at $10 and up. Green flag back in the air. Rusty Ballinger in the 29 machine working off the corner in that Warrior race car entry. The 07 machine now going to work into turn number one and two. That is Bailey Cardwell out of Knoxville, Tennessee. Terry Poore in the 2P machine. Caution flag is out. End everything for the first group out on the Speedway for the American All-Star Series. I want to thank Peep and Dragon Photography, the official photographer of the series, Miss Tara.
So while we have just a little bit of a break in the action, if you own what looks to be like a late 60s, early 70s model red Volkswagen Bug that's parked over by the pit gate, we have been informed that you have left your lights on. Once again, if you own a red Bug parked over there by the pit entrance, you have left your lights on, as we want to make sure you're able to leave here tonight.
Fastest out of the first group, Zach Sice, fastest overall. Followed by Tyler Price, Dakota Smith, Matthew Jordan, Trevor Sice. And actually, Trevor going to jump up to second fastest there, Rusty Ballinger. Third is race monitor updated there. Zach Sice fastest with a 13.471. Trevor Sice just a tenth off with a 13.472. Rusty Ballinger, third fastest. Tyler Price, fourth fastest. Bailey Cardwell, fifth fastest. Terry Poore, Dakota Smith, and Matthew Jordan, the eight drivers that took time in that first group. Of course, this is hot laps, and it does not pay a dime as we get ready to roll the second group, and they are coming out onto the Speedway. The 9 machine of Josh Dietz, the driver out of Kentucky, going to lead them in this group, this second group, Group B. Ricky Green, the driver out of Newton, North Carolina, in the 18 machine, a winner last season at the Pro Lake Mono Nationals at Whiff Raceway in that 18 machine. Sylvan Chute out of Blairsville, Georgia, in the 14 machine. Little Caesars on the side of his ride in the 66. That is Deke Waters. The current points leader signified with the yellow spoiler, a CVR race car, R&W Properties. Morgan McClure also on the side of his ride. That is the driver of the 22 machine, Hayden Cardwell. He has scored multiple wins throughout the season this year. Arville Pittman in the 77. Also out on the Speedway as well, working through turn number one and two. Chris McKinney in the 113 out of Harriman, Tennessee, working his way to the start of the back straightaway. Fast Fab on that 14 machine up for Sylvan Chute. Here we go. Green flag in the air. Deke Waters in the 66 machine. Hayden Cardwell in the 22 machine. Cardwell diving off into turn number three and four. Chris McKinney behind him in the 113. Josh Dietz in the 9 machine. The 89 of Brandon Miller, also in a CVR race car entry, working down into turn number 1 and 2. The 18 machine of Ricky Green, running through turn number 3 and 4, the KRC restart zone flags you see down there in 3 and 4 to signify our restart area here for the American All-Star Series. White flag, white rag in air for Group B. Down the back straightaway, Cardwell going to look down into the corner of the racetrack, already starting to take some black and some rubber in the middle groove. Checkered flag in the air. Josh Deeds with a great little slider on the 113 there. Brandon Miller back to the line in that 89 machine, a driver out of Maryville, Tennessee. Hayden Cardwell, new fast time with a 13.391. Then it's Zach Seiss, Trevor Seiss. Still right there, second and third on the speed charts, followed by Deke Waters in the 66 with a 13.500. Rusty Ballinger, Tyler Price, Brandon Miller, Bailey Cardwell, Josh Dietz, Terry Poore. That's your top 10 so far here in Hot Laps. But remember, Hot Laps does not pay a dime. We'll come back for actual qualifying coming up a little bit later on here in the evening. Open wheel modifieds, be on standby. Open wheel modifieds, please be on standby. American All-Star Series merchandise at the crossover gate to the pit area race victory. That is Josh Boo Henry. Talk about a sharp, brand new ride. They debuted it last weekend, that Z1 machine of Zach Shannon out of Wartburg, Tennessee. That is a sharp looking race car as he rolls it out onto the speedway. Behind him, it's going to be the 10B machine of Bradley Llewellyn. Bradley Llewellyn out of Seymour, Tennessee. Behind him, the 24 of Philip Thomas. Rolling out onto the speedway. Whitesburg, Tennessee is where he calls home. In that 24, he is very, very fast over at Volunteer Speedway in their 604 Lake Model Division. In the 50, Floyd Turner out of Crossville, Tennessee. He's picked up a win or two here in local competition this season in that 50 machine. Behind him, in the 116, the little Dream Weaver himself. That is Cameron Weaver, also out of Crossville, Tennessee. Two of the hometown favorites working their way down the front straightaway. Another driver who is always a fan favorite in the 32 machine, William Blankenship. Blankenship Farms on that machine. That is an Excel Racing chassis. Excel Racing chassis made in Greenville, South Carolina by Tim and Lee Cooper as he works down the front straightaway. Behind him, a driver running for the Rookie of the Year contention out of the great state of Kentucky, Junction City, Kentucky to be precise. That is the 14W of Logan Walls as he works down the front straightaway. Behind him, in the 7, that is Austin Breedlove, also out on the speedway as well. Open wheel modifieds. Be ready in staging, please. Open wheel modifieds. Be ready in staging. I said Hayden Cardwell has been fastest so far in this hot lap session over Zach Seiss, Trevor Seiss, Deke Waters, Rusty Ballinger, your top 5 so far in hot laps. Savage Racing chassis at the Oaks on the side for Josh Boo Henry, the driver to Newport, Tennessee. Be clean, pressure washing a CVR for Bradley Llewellyn out of Seymour, Tennessee. Zach Shannon in that Z1 machine out of Wartburg, Tennessee. Service 101 on that machine for Phil Thompson. And here we go, getting ready to turn them loose. Loud pedal to the floor. Green flag is in the air. Bradley Llewellyn and Floyd Turner. Working down into turn number 1, Cameron Weaver. Behind them in the 116, Phil Thompson in the 24. Josh Boo Henry has had some great runs over the last couple of years here at Crossville Speedway. Couple of podium finishes for that machine for the Boo crew. Floyd Turner picking up some wins this season here at Crossville Speedway in a regular competition. Of course, Crossville Speedway, one of the American All-Star Series weekly tracks presented by Rick Hendricks City Chevrolet for that weekly championship. I want to thank Dirt Media, our official television partner, American Racers, O'Reilly Auto Parts, Pro Fabrication, Terrier Race Cars, CVR, Smoky Mountain Speedway, Mountain Motorsports Park in Kentucky. We continue to pray for those folks in Kentucky who have been hit so hard with this horrible flooding. Hopefully, everybody is able to rebuild there in the great state of Kentucky and get things back to normal somewhat in the next couple of months after those horrible floods hit the area. How about the 24 of Phil Thompson? Like I said, he is always a threat at Volunteer Speedway in that 24 machine, and he is fastest in hot laps over Hayden Cardwell with a 13.356. New fast time goes to the 24 machine of Phil Thompson. He goes to the top of the board over Hayden Cardwell, Zach Seiss, Trevor Seiss, Deke Waters, Rusty Ballinger, Tyler Price, Brandon Miller, William Blankenship, your top 10 here in Hot Laps for the American All-Star Series, presented by PPM Racing Products. Open wheel modifieds getting ready to roll down the hill for their time out on the speedway. And as they get ready to roll down the hill, we'll turn things back over to the voice of Crossville Speedway and, once again, I-75 Raceway, Eric Henry.
Drive, you need to be making your way to staging as well. So here we go with your open wheel modifieds. You're going to look down, you're going to see the 11. And that beautiful looking halo back number 11 of Chris Wilson. Cameron Wilson in the M&W towing back number 5. Matthew Hopper in the 92. Kurt Turner, Joey Wittenberg, and Chris Payne going to be right here in your first group. As we need group number 2, you need to be in staging. Steelheads, you need to be in staging as well. Steelheaded late models, you need to be there. So as the caution's going to fly on group number 1, with the open wheel modifieds, got a car looped around over there in the top of turn number 4, trying to get a visual. That looks like it's going to be the 5 of Chris Wilson. Cameron Wilson, I apologize. So group number two looks like it's going to consist of the 28C of Jeff Cotterman. In that CNC collision, back to number 28, Adam Wright going to be in the 88. Then you got Justin Parker also in the 88P. And the Reckless Auto Sports Dreamscape Landscaping, number 99 of Shannon Elrod. And you're going to look down on the front straightaway. That's going to be the Midas of Cookeville, back to number 5M. Picked up two feature wins so far here at Crossville Speedway on the 2022 season. Also backed by Shelton's detailing right there on Willow Avenue. That's going to be Scott Shelton. Then you got the 29C out of Cookeville, Tennessee, also backed by CNC Collision, as we're going to go underway in group number two of your opener modifieds. So fastest so far in your open wheel modified hot laps, going to go to the 11 of Chris Wilson. Joey Cotterman going to be second. Scott Shelton going to be third. Kirk Turner and Jeff Cotterman, your top five. As we get ready to roll down your steel-headed late models. Front wheel drives, you need to be in staging for hot lap qualifying. Front wheel drive, you need to be in staging. Thunder cars, Thunder division, you need to be making your way to staging at this time. So you're still headed late model hot laps. Looks like it's going to be the 617 to Colton Prophet. Going to be fastest so far. Robbie Chancellor going to be in the 17. Tracy Denton, Jamie McElhaney, and then Jonathan Denton. So group number one looks like it's going to be the 617. The Colton Prophet going to be your fast time so far, as this is hot lap qualifying. So while we got a little bit of a break in between the two classes, got to say something, thank you to all the sponsors here at Crossville Speedway, making sure we can swing these gates open every Friday night. Big shout out to Stowers Caterpillar and Rental up here in Crossville, Tennessee, for bringing down the lights for the pits tonight, making sure everybody's safe over in the pits and can see what's going on. Also, a big shout out to the Race TN Series. They're going to be racing at the Putnam County Fair Sunday afternoon. Gates are going to open around 4 o'clock, so come on down, ATV and motorcycle racing at the Putnam County Fair. And we can't say enough about Hey Jack Construction, as they are the presenting sponsor for tonight's racing event for the Hey Jack Construction 40. So we're going to turn loose group number two. That's going to be Max Stout, Brian Hancock, and Stephen Conley. Stephen Conley, a fresh name around the Crossville Speedway. So Colton Prophet still going to be at the top of the board. Then it's going to be Stephen Conley, Robbie Chancellor, Jamie McElhaney, Tracy Denton, Jonathan Denton, Max Stout, and Brian Hancock. Going to round out your still-headed late models as we roll down into your third and final group.
Let me see. Just tell it to be listening for a second, because Willie's going to talk on it. They're on the same channel as we are. It's like, hey, can you ask Willie if he'll do it? I don't want to walk on top of him.
So here we go with the third and final group, and you're still hitting late models. Michael Smith, going to be in the 15. Jeff Walker, your 2017 track champion in your sportsman late model division. So once again, ladies and gentlemen, make sure that you check out our concession stands. Get yourself something hot to eat, cold to drink. As I think we're going to have to start serving coffee and hot chocolate here before long. So up here on the Cumberland Plateau, gets a little chilly. So I'm going to roll down your front wheel drive hot lap qualifying. So here we go, J5 of J.D. Humphrey going to be your fast time as now the 90 of Spivey going to take over that top spot. Jacob Sharp going to take it back once again. We've got one heck of a battle. So Jacob Sharp now going to be at the top of the board. Cody Richter going to be second. Dustin Duncan, Amelia McLean fourth. And Mike Jones fifth. Yeah. So still the one of Jacob Sharp at the top of the board. As that will conclude our hot lap qualifying for your front wheel drive division. Thunder Cars, you should be in staging. Thunder Cars, you should be in staging. Junior, front wheel drive, you need to be in staging. Junior, front wheel drive, you need to be in staging. So here we go with your Thunder Division. These are just a slight bit different than your street stocks. These run automatic transmissions. So once again, Junior front wheel drive, you need to be in staging. Junior front wheel drive, you need to be in staging. And American Pro Late Model Series, you need to be making your way to staging for time trials. So Justin Turner going to be at the top of the board. As that was hot laps for your Thunder Division. You'll see them again here in just a little bit for heat races. Junior front wheel drives, you should be there. Junior front wheel drive, you need to be there. And American Pro Late Model Series, you need to be making your way to staging for time trials. So once again, Junior front wheel drives and the American Pro Late Model Series. You need to be in staging for your Racing for Christ time trials. So you got Frankie Sharp and Ronnie Sharp out there in your front wheel drive division, junior front wheel drive division.
Whoa! Ronnie, you smoking, bud. He's putting down fluid.
Got a lot of fluid.
And I don't know if you've ever tried to direct these kids.
Shut her down.
If you ever tried to direct these kids, it's like trying to get a bunch of kittens in one area. It's not happening.
We run
for the kids at Beckley mini wedges, and they're little go-karts. Mm-hmm.